7, Direfall Covenant, and she is up. I finished the main story, so I'm free to go on, naturally, through the story arc of the game, to Glenumbra. But I am doing it my way. So, here we go.
I assume your family wasn't especially pleased so with an outsider prying into our affairs.
She wants to go out and travel the world before she gets married. You know, her parents have her set to marry a chief. She can be a chief's wife for her village, for the island. But what happened is she wants to go off and explore the world. But if she leaves the island without her family's blessing, she'll be exiled. And she wants, like, she'll marry the guy. She wants to marry him, you know. But she doesn't want to do it now, because if she does, she's going to stay here. You know, and she won't be able to go anywhere. She wants to travel the world beforehand. But if she leaves without her parents' permission, she'll get exiled. So it's either stay and do what your family wants you to do and make them happy, or leave and never be able to return. And do what you want to do.
So what's your opinion, after talking to everyone? I really want to know.
Your marriage is vital to your clan. There's honor in doing that. So, it's basically telling you to stay on the island and don't pursue your dream. Or, your life is your own. Sail with us and see the world, if that's what you want. I want to make her do the right thing. You know, because this will keep her safe, like, for her own protection. Otherwise, she won't be able to come back. But fuck it. Your life is your own.
You're right. I value my family. But this is my life. I should live it as I choose. I'm gonna follow my heart.
Glad I could help.
At last, I find myself looking forward to my future.
Oh. Yeah, sucky nose.
Yes. I'll say my farewells first. It won't be easy. But I won't sneak out like a thief. My family has a right to hear it from my lips. I'll see you on the ship when you're ready to leave.
With the main quest, it basically ended up, you know, the evil cultists were raising the dead to take over the island from the orcs. So what they did is they dug up an ancient weapon from the battle of the orcs when they burst at the island. I'm rambling. Basically, they have a weapon that can raise the dead all over the island and have them fight for you. You have to stop it. You do. But then you have the humans, the regular people on the island, versus who are with the main covenant, versus the orcs who live here. Basically saying, oh, destroy it. The orcs are saying, destroy it. Those are the souls of our people. And you have to set them free. But the regular people are saying, no, you can use this as a weapon. You have to decide. And I chose to destroy it. You know, start with the orcs. And basically, the whole human crew said, fuck you. And didn't want me to stay with them anymore. So, my character's kind of fucked. But since I decided to please the chieftain ordered them to take me back to Glenumbra so he could join the covenant. Dodge! Kamehameha! Bitch. Okay. Now I don't know where I'm going. I'm just killing shit, I guess. You know, that's my homework. Yeah. Spider eggs, yummy and delicious. Oh, I thought you were iron. You're not iron. Yeah, there's really not much that I didn't explore. Well, I guess if this is like a small... Yeah, I did not go over here at all. Whoa, yeah, I did. Yep, that was, yeah, so this place is quite limited. Okay. Yeah, we basically started off the island, the game, on the island of Joseph Mackay. You know? Where, I'm in no mood to explain the whole story. I'll do it in another video. But basically, we did shit on this island and set sail for this island. So we can set sail afterwards to the mainland. Woo! Pump it up. Chop. I'm gonna chop you. Chop the wood with my axe. This is my Breton iron. What the fuck? Oh, hell no, Scrappy. Bad boy. Scrappy. Oh boy. Scrappy's gone. Ooh, a rune. I'm quite the enchantress, I guess you'd say. In this playthrough, this game, to my character. Sit, stay, play dead. Good boy. I'm also a loot whore, but I'm getting better with it. So now that I'm grabbing everything, I'll grab the shit I actually need, and I'll sort that into something I'm actually gonna use. It makes sense in my head. Sneak up on the wolf. The hunter becomes the hunted. Not gonna level up that quickly. I've got the skill. This is good to my main strategy, I guess. You know, I'm more of a DPS, so this would be strategically good to me to use, you know. No, not that one, but no, yeah. Oh, wrong. Sure. Magic. This one. That would be really good to get, strategically. I don't like investing in some skills. Oh, dear, Scrappy. Yeah, good boy, Scrappy. Scrappy, don't die. What's my inventory? Alright, slow you down. Why are you treating this game as stupid? It's good, but it's stupid. Watch. You shoot. Like you have infinite arrows. You know, it's like, you're automatically assumes you're a genius with it. I like in Skyrim better, you know, where you actually get perks that level you up with it. Like, oh, you can do this faster now, smoother. You'll get more draws, arrows, and shit from bodies. You know, something makes you actually work for it. Makes you feel like you're doing better when you level up by doing it more and more. This one, no, it takes all the fun out of it, and it's stupid. You know, it's not like, okay, oh shit, I'm actually out of arrows. You have to actually conserve it. No, it's just fire away. I get it for a game conveniency. Because you'll be loot farming arrows constantly. What's that talking about? I could totally rock an arrow. Now the abilities, you know, for the skills, for arrows, are pretty cool, you know. Shoot poison arrows, do poison damage, aim at a correct circle in the ground, and then fire, and then basically it rains arrows on them, like you shot a bushel of arrows at once. So like that's actually pretty cool. But I don't know. I guess games just have happy medium. Skyrim, everyone had skill. And here, everyone has class. You're not a iron. Also, you don't need to aim as well. You know, like if I find the general direction of this bug. I guess not. I just want combat. You know, it's like, hey, just get away. You can fuck arrows at him. I swear, if this is what the world would be like in apocalypse, volume of focus won't survive. I promise you. Well, you want to make something that go dig shit out for yourself? Whoa. Despawn like a motherfucker. Okay. Yes. Not really big on collecting gems. Maybe every once in a while, but yeah, I get it with stuff that would make this game like slightly more hard, but make like actual vantage points for when you're fighting enemies, you know? Like, I guess it's an online game, you can't really do that, like in Fallout. But like, if I shoot the thorax, you know, right about there, that's just mysterious damage. Same as though if you shoot him, generally, it may be in the face, you know? Can I get anatomically correct? I swear to God, this motherfucker. I should have gotten the fucking other one, but I love you, Scruffy. But yeah, he always makes this growling noise, so I think like other imps or fucking spiders or wolves are around me. Stop getting your brother for help. That's really cool. How like Pathfinder and Dungeons and Dragons are based the Bible, you know, the formula used in Dungeons and Dragons, the whole dice system, all that formulates into games like this, you know, like in Fallout, you know, you put books in Charisma. Charisma is one of the actual stats you have, and the points in that actually change your personality. It does what Charisma does, you know, it makes you easier to talk to. Trust you more.
That's not you, I smell, is it?
People who put points in strength, their characters are just naturally stronger, you know? Dexterity, you know, more agile, you can do more, earn faster, you know, good reflexes, I guess. Then you have intelligence, how book smart you are, how good you study, you know, knowledge. Then you've got wisdom, which is common sense. So anyways, I digress. Sorry, supplies. I always see to you with this shit, sorry. I just got my little remote player on. I just save it. Back in 1 second, guys. Sorry. Sorry about that. Or wait, no. Sorry about that. Sorry about that, guys. Alright, I'm not talking about this game. Not so much, no. I'll save it. Later on, maybe. Not sure if like I wanna get to 15 and start a new class, new weapon. And yes, this is Imperious. No.
I swore never to sail with you again, but Chief Tazgul has asked me to sail you to Glenumbra, which I will do. Only out of respect for the Chief and for the good of the Alliance, not for you. Are you ready to go?
Yeah, let's go. To Glenumbra, our home, home state. Yeah. Stefan, PewDiePie. He's one of the people who got me into gaming first, like to watch people gaming and actually record gaming. PewDiePie. Yeah.
We've arrived. Welcome to Daggerfall.
That's pretty cool because people I got on her quest, like this guy. This guy. And shit, Buster. This one. And they would actually follow me on quests. They help me out and shit.
Daggerfall. I can't believe I'm here. I've read stories. But the story itself is inspiring. I can't wait to go
Yeah, pretty right choice.
When the elves attack our shores and hundreds of our soldiers die, I want you to remember the choice you made. If you had kept that relic, we could have saved those soldiers. You made the wrong choice.
Don't just put me on the battlefield. I can't die.
We're here, in Daggerfall. Now get off my boat.
Jeez. Just trying to keep it from imprisoning souls.
I wish I could have retrieved that alien relic for study, but you were wise to destroy it rather than place it in Breton hands.
See, I know I like this guy.
I realize Colleen disagrees with your decision, but never doubt it was the right one.
He's been like the nerd of the group, but he's pretty chill.
I was so certain I wanted to sail with Captain Colleen, but I still can't believe she was in favor of keeping that awful relic. I think I might take Lambour's offer and join her crew.
Wow.
Well now, a familiar face! How good to see you! Honestly, I'm beginning to wonder if I'm on the wrong ship.
Come on, bro. I have a main quest to do. That was my story quest for this game. Damn, it's already been 26 minutes. Shit. Everything else I do in this game will be for me. Character development and whatnot. Cause you
you're not my type.
Prostitution, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight. All these squares make a circle. All these squares make a circle. Yeah. Ooh, the dance. Kira. Hey, girl.
Expect the worst, and you can only be pleasantly surprised.
Maybe best friends, Daggerfall Guard. I'm gonna call you Sally. Wait, is this motherfucker still with me? He's not? Yes. Okay, cool. I'm not the freak with the demon cut anymore. Yeah.
The proud city of Daggerfall greets you. Can I help you with something? You've seen that war chief. Impressive. I don't know what you did to convince him, friend. But you have my gratitude. Well done.
I know I did it.
I will take this petition to High King Emmerich immediately. Enjoy your stay in Daggerfall.
Whoa. So, I've seen this before. If I don't talk to him, walk away, he'll appear later on in someone's town.
There you are, Vestige. We must speak at once.
This is my main quest now. Okay.
Listen well. I have located a safe harbor from which we might plan our course of action.
Okay, Dumbledore.
You must meet me there.
Where is the safe harbor?
I awoke in a city of Bretons, its air heavy with the smells of baked bread, horses, and intrigue. Daggerfall. The harborage is in an abandoned cave.
I need the brochure
outside the city.
Dude. I'll find you there. City yet? Yes, do shit. This just sparked a big flashback, so I'm not sure if I want to go through that right now, or I want to go just see the town. I'm gonna see the town first. Going to see the guards. Yeah, what the? Oh, now I'm good. Wow, look at this city, I'm bored already. It's like a discount solitude. Shit, I'm also kinda mad because this was the map I used on my first playthrough. When I first played the game, and I just lost this spot, so.
I think of trouble as an opportunity to practice my sword playing.
Welcome to the bank.
And most of this, you see that other player, and all this stuff is from both of us, but mostly with the other player. Yeah. So let's deposit some shit, shall we? There's something with this city.
Greetings.
Choose skill points. Cool. Save them till later. Later. Woodworking, carpentry. Where is it? It's in here, isn't it? I'm a dumbass, aren't I? Yes, I am.
Hello. That damn dog keeps approaching me. I think it wants me to follow it.
The dog probably wants a handout. Like
dog?
Peasants in the city.
What dog?
At least a dog won't bite the hand that feeds it.
What dog is anyone talking about? I'm thoroughly confused. No, it's clothing. It's blacksmithing. Clothing. Where's woodworking? Oh, there's no clothing. No woodworking. Oh, here it is. I'll come here woodwork.
Speak softly.
Oh shit.
Hey there.
Hi there.
Can you hear me?
Yeah?
Jump up and down if you can hear me.
Huh? What'd you say?
you come here for crafting certification?
Cursed pig thieves! Thieves! Daggerfall is full of them. They steal anything that's not nailed down. They stole my livestock. This was no simple robbery. It was grand larceny. And I know who did it. The Font stole my glutton. He's been itching to put my prized pig on his menu, serve him up in a stew at his wretched inn. Glutton's missing, and I just know La Font. They said to take it up with the magistrate, but that takes too long. Poor Glutton doesn't have that much time. I need someone to rescue him before he becomes a ham sandwich.
Lord of Thought. He's French. He's a dirty rotten pig stealer. I need a friend.
Welcome to the Rosy Lion, friend. Have a seat, and I'll pour you a mug. Did he say I stole his damn hog again? I didn't. Not this time, not last time, not ever. Do you see a pig on a spit in here? Most likely Glutton broke out and started rooting in the alleys again. Every time the pig escapes, Glutton accuses me of thievery. Every time! Ugh, what a nuisance. Look, check the alleys in the northeast section of the city. The sooner that pig's found, the sooner Wickton will shut up and leave me in peace. Go on. I'm sure you'll find that hog of a pig rooting around in the northeast alleys.
Let's go find a pig. I might like that guy.
You're not drinking enough. Go buy yourself a mug of something strong. And get one for me while you're over there.
Narla. This is our name, Narla. Narwhal. Narla. Yeah. Piggy! Piggy! Piggy whip, Piggy! Get away from that.
Live to reveal our secret.
Oh. I am not upstairs. Bitch. Blackthorn, but no, they were on the island. Oh no, Blackthorn, they followed us here. Well, they're post people of Glenumber now. Killing a chicken here is a crime. That's what's fucked up. You destroyed someone's livestock.
You found him! You found my wonderful little Glutton! I bet La Font was hiding him there, until he could turn poor Glutton into ribs and chops. But now I've got my prized pig back. La Font's guilty of something, I'm sure of it. But what do I care about strange vines? Talk to Jagosh over by the Mage's Guild if you're so interested. He knows his plans. Sold me some herbs one time when a glutton ate something that upset his tummy.
Someone new to talk to. Are you here for something specific or just to say hello? A strange vine. Unusually thick and covered in thorns? In the city? Son of a troll! I've seen such vines to the north. They're connected to the Bloodthorn cult. Be wary of those vines. Wherever they appear, the Bloodthorn... Well, don't dawdle. Ask your questions. I don't have all. They're death mages led by the cursed Reachman Angoff, the Gravesinger. I heard they were causing trouble north of Glenumbra. They must be getting bolder if they're operating in Daggerfall. Angoff's a Reachman, one of those magic-cursed savages from the border of Bankorai. But he's more than that. He's a necromancer. They call him Gravesinger because he made a deal with the Daedric Prince, Molag Bal.
Two rockets. Hi, Wolfie. Bad Wolfie. Five experience are coming to us. Yeah, that's not gonna do it for me. I did the thing, but the thing is the guy speeds. Is that bad? Am I gonna die? Marla is an animal serial killer. Which will I passed it.
I hear familiar footfalls. Come closer, Vestige.
I guess we'll call it a night. We'll do the rest of this later.